cloud computing. Just what is your understanding and expectation from this rapidly advancing technology? What about the challenging environment of security or the complicated process of compliance? What major changes have happened over the last decade around cloud computing? And what's next? How do you remain competitive, not only today, but in tomorrow's global digital economy? Greetings, everyone. It's Friday, January 16th, 2015. Welcome from the Technology Association of Georgia. This is Tech Talk, and I'm your host, Frank Baia. Focus on this edition of Tech Talk, virtualization services and the ever-growing, more disruptive impact of cloud computing. Up to today's Tech Talk focus, who better than Butch Goldi, Regional Vice President, Southeast for QTS Data Centers. Butch joined QTS in 2009. His prior experience spans decades of top leadership positions at the industry's leading innovative and pioneering data center services companies. Having come from Internap as Director of Sales, as well as XO Communications, where he served as that organization's General Manager. Earlier, Butch provided leadership for the East Region of Alliance Telecom as Regional Vice President. Add his military service highlighting technology, Butch has more than 35 years of technical, sales, and management experience. Over the last 5 years, QTS, the company, has enjoyed considerable growth, and the Southeast region now represents 65% of the company's annual revenue. Pretty notable when considering QTS has over 40% of the data center market share. It's the insights from a pioneering executive, as well as one of the industry's top thought leadership authorities. It's a Tech Talk on virtualized services and cloud computing, from security to compliance and the competitive performance to not only maintain your position in the marketplace, but to grow in the face of new opportunities. As we Tech Talk with QTS Regional Vice President Southeast, Butch Goldi. This edition of Tech Talk is brought to you by GlobalSpeak.com, new media consultants, corporate video and audio communications, video and audio production and distribution, live and virtual event production. Tag TV and Tag Radio is a service of GlobalSpeak.com, creatively delivering powerful marketing, video, and audio solutions. Butch, welcome to Tech Talk.
Hey, thank you, Frank. Good to see you again.
Well, it's been, I'm going to guess, about 2006 since the first time you and I spoke about virtualized services, and that was pretty kind of far out at the time, but a lot of the thought leadership and vision that you shared with us back then actually has materialized, but all over the course of like almost a decade, 7 years, I guess, or so, major changes. What have you seen over the last 7 years about around, especially around cloud computing?
Yeah, you know, the technology has changed drastically, Frank. The UCS chassis out there today that are, basically a prepackaged wrap infrastructure that gives the customer the ability to have a one-stop shop, so to speak, it's taken virtualization to another level. Mm-hmm. VMware, Cisco, and EMC, along with the, the local representation here in this marketplace that they go out and move that product.
Well, obviously, customer understanding and expectation, I'm going to guess, has changed. And then that four-letter word called compliance, which everybody seems to be frustrated or pretty much has got a primary target of concern. Go into a little bit about those.
Yeah, so, one thing about the customer's understanding, everyone has their own interpretation of what a cloud is or what a cloud should be. And I think that's evolved over time. A lot of the clouds back, 7-8 years ago that we talked about, was really on a dedicated infrastructure or maybe some shared, but today, again, with the large infrastructures that are out there today, you can put a lot more clients on one piece of physical hardware. And then the other customer's understanding is now customers look more intelligent or more knowledgeable, have done their research on the web and things of that nature to what they're looking for, and then we can point them in the right direction towards what's the best solution. Around compliance, it's really, you want to make sure that you're meeting all the SOC requirements today, and that's the compliance itself has changed over the years as well. So, it's understanding what the customer's requirements and needs are. It's understanding how to put them on the correct platform so that they maintain the compliance within their industry.
Eastern philosophers say that they give you all these wisdoms, and at the very end they say, but I could be wrong. You know, I often wonder how a subject matter expert, someone with the kind of vision and leadership that you provided, and especially at QTS, how you look into the future and not only give your customers the kind of advice, kind of consulting and services that you do, but how do you remain competitive in the marketplace? Talk a little bit about, specifically a cloud offering, but how do you remain competitive in the marketplace?
Now, I think overall, let's talk about it from a co-location standpoint first. We've got some formidable competitors out there. Atlanta's a very attractive marketplace, as you're well aware of.
Sure.
I think one of the things that we do is we look at whether it's a wholesale arrangement, what we call the C1 product, or whether it's an enterprise or a custom build for those type of folks. That's a separate market, so we're competing with a different type of individual. And the C2 arena, where we call basically cages and cabinets, and that mid-sized customer, a lot of competition in that sector of the business here. A lot of people wanting to get into Atlanta to get into that business, and I think there's plenty for everyone. But we maintain competitive in that area, but it's also the customer service that we support. So there's a value add to our product. And I think we have a great sales organization that's able to communicate that accurately. And then lastly, the cloud.
Go ahead.
Lastly, the cloud. And, in the cloud, what happened is, in 2006, 2007, when we started providing cloud services through QVI, which is Quality Virtual Infrastructure, we knew that we needed to enhance that product. So we now have QTS Enterprise Cloud, which basically hands the customer a resource pool, and they do what they like with the VMs. They make them as large or as small as they want. And then now we just recently were announced that we had FedRAMP. So we're FedRAMP compliant company, and we have a dedicated federal cloud as well.
Hmm. Well, you mentioned, just touch upon C1 and C2, and obviously things are moving rapidly in the C2 direction without any question. Natural progression, or is it something that requires a little bit of thought process and work and investment?
I think it's a natural progression because we find that most clients that are having co-location today, whether it's on the enterprise scale or on the C2 scale, which is that small to medium-sized customer, they're all investigating the cloud. So why would you want to physically move out of a data center to go to another provider when that provider has cloud offering for you? So one of the things that we offer is the ability to say, as your equipment comes to end of life, and it's time to do a technology refresh, well, you don't need to go off and look at another cloud provider. You don't need to go look at Amazon or whatever it is. You can stay right with QTS and migrate your services over to us and keep it close to the infrastructure that you still want to maintain.
People you know and trust, and you have done business with, literally, as we talked about, over a decade or so of not only evolution but revolution, and stayed the course, and we're a trusted ally and vendor. Let's talk a little bit about, at some point, the bottom line is delivery. And when you guys talk about it, everybody kind of, brings it up and talks about customer service and delivery as part of their, core competencies, part of their value-added proposition. But this offering is pretty strong about from you guys' standpoint, and you do it so well. Talk a little bit about delivery.
Yeah, one of the things that I think makes us unique in the industry is that we do offer those three C's, and with those three C's, you now have a greater need for back office support. So we have 450 experts within our data centers, and those experts can do everything from network to storage and everything in between, as well as the colo and the power and things of that nature. So you have a dedicated team that we walk you through the process. So after you sign up with QTS and you become a valued customer, we partner with you to put you in the right category, what we call a customer advocate, customer implementation, and we walk you through the process, whether it's co-location or cloud. So that team is dedicated to you during the implementation process, and then afterwards, we do a quarterly checkup with you to make sure that we've met all your expectations, the billing is correct. So high emphasis on the, what we call an operations service center. We don't call it a NOC. But the service center knows who you are when you call in. You have the customer advocate team that's there to support you on a quarterly basis. Your sales representatives will be involved in that as well. So we spend a lot of time and money in training these individuals, keeping them at the top level of their skill sets, and then as well as make sure that they receive that, that customer receives that premium experience.
It's hard to bring up the cloud and not bring up cybersecurity, and security risk is part of the concerns from the enterprise standpoint for sure. A lot of challenges, a lot of opportunities, but From your perspective, what are some of the security risks that come along with moving to the cloud? And I guess really the bottom line, is there anything that we can do about it? And what do you guys have in place to counteract the risk?
I mean, there's a number of things. You know, Frank, they can get to you through a number of different ways. So denial of service attacks, intrusion detection, those things in nature. So we check you all the way from the Internet access portion of it all the way to encrypting your data at rest if we're responsible for it from a cloud standpoint. So if you're a healthcare organization, and Gina Hill is one of my sales representatives that is an expert in that area, we'll actually sign a business associate agreement with you, which says that we're responsible for the information at rest. And with that, we'll encrypt that information. So we're doing our part. I think people need to do a better investigation of, where their attacks can come, and then we obviously have the expertise that can assist them to do that.
Butch, as always, great stuff. Thank you for taking time from your busy schedule to join us today on Tech Talk.